here you have the control of the camera. So this one will go up and down, and this one will go left. This one is stuck. Some people were a bit afraid. I think they were afraid to crash the equipment, but very quickly they get confident with this kind of new drone technology, with a lot of sensors that are avoiding obstacles and this kind of thing. People very quickly get confident, and actually you can almost, I am sure everybody can pilot this kind of drone very easily.
In agriculture, also forestry, to
Because I was in this vegetation mapping tropical coming in Indonesia, it was a reason to come in Indonesia. So at that time we were doing vegetation map in Sumatra, for instance. And at that time, so that's the beginning of the 80s, you get starting to work with satellite data. And we realized very quickly that with satellite, sometimes it's difficult to interpret what's exactly on the ground and this kind of thing. So the idea of getting closer to the ground to get a kind of intermediate scale between the satellite and what we see on the ground, for me that's quite natural since so many years. It's a kind of map that the local community appreciate very much because it really gives them a good view of their area. Here at C4 we do a lot of work with forest and communities. So that's typical, the tool that is probably the best because of the details that you can show on the map. You do very precise mapping. And before, when we do participatory mapping with people, it's always kind of sketch map. And when you bring the sketch map to the authorities, for instance, they will say, oh yeah, that's nice, but it's not legal, it's not at scale. So now we do this kind of very precise mapping at a proper scale. And then it's much better for the community. For our own research, I think there is no question about it. Oh, drone, are you really sure you want to buy a drone, this kind of thing? But now everybody is really enthusiastic about it.